evening and welcome to Tinkering with Etkalar. Since I'm still swamped with work and obligations, here's yet another smaller project to keep things moving. I have to do these smaller things eventually, right? Last year, I ordered a batch of 4 different dictaphones to go with my 1403 Pocket PC. I restored one of them, as you can see in the video here, and put away the others for later. Well, it is later now, so here's the second of the bunch. It is a more modern Sony device, M-570V. It's for microcassettes and features dual speed and voice activated recording. I didn't consider it for data storage because it doesn't come with a microphone input connector. Only the built-in microphone is available. The case shows some serious scuff marks on the plastic. The unit must have been kept in a compartment of sorts. Maybe it also had contact with some battery spill? Hard to tell. Electronics is pretty advanced for these devices. Lots of surface mounted stuff and 2 integrated circuits. I start with the usual stuff, recapping and cleaning the switches and potentiometers, at least the through-hole components. The motor is a brushless one, so the speed is controlled by a crystal. Thank you. disassembling the drive mechanism next. There are many plastic clips holding things in place. I really need a source for those. They are hard to remove intact. Oh, f**k! No. Darn. That spring is now somewhere. Lost in space. I have excavated my desk and turned everything upside down twice. No luck. Now that all the parts are separated, I use my ultrasonic cleaner to get rid of the dust and grime. Rebuilding. Again, looking at all the reference pictures and videos. I didn't find a service manual for this one. A sandwich of pressed sheet metal and tiny springs. Some parts are pressed in, so I couldn't remove those, but I did remove everything else. And now, that missing spring. After understanding the mechanism, I now know that it's the return spring for seek play. The forward reverse lever will be snapped back into center position, but only during seek. For normal forward reverse, a different spring is doing the job. So it has to be quite sturdy. I found a bit of spring wire in my stash. Let's get bending! The wire I had was slightly too thick. I'll maybe replace that at some later time, but it does the job. So, on with the assembly! ¶¶ I tried to paint the case to cover up the scuff marks, but that silver color is hard to get just right. Another maybe for later, repaint and do the silk printing for the labels. Soldering all the wires back on. And adding batteries for a test run. Will it work? Success! All the functions are working. The audio quality is about as bad as to be expected from microcassettes, but hey, it's for voice memos. And you wouldn't believe what turned up when ironing my shirt from last week. Yes, it fell into my pocket and made it all through the wash. Good evening and welcome to Tinkering with Edgar. And that's it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed watching as much as I enjoyed making it. See you next time! The wire I had was slightly too thick. Pay me? Oh, maybe.